Hello, well, well then. Hello there. Friends and newcomers alike, welcome to the stream. My name is Douglas, I'm a coffee boy. Coffee. And welcome. Today we're gonna be working on more of that same thing we were doing before. By before I mean yesterday-ish, which is comic book things. But to begin today's stream, I'd like to begin with something slightly different from the comic. Let me go and show you. Also, hello Nikolai and Kazi. Welcome to the stream to both of you. How are you guys doing today this morning? So let me change the music from this current music to the Good Boy Bot music, because I know how much you love them. So here we are, Clip Studio Paint. Yeah, Clip Studio Paint. That's the name of the program. It's not a very pleasant name. It doesn't roll off the tongue, but it's the name. Anyway, here we have it. It's a happy face saying hello. Clip Studio. That's the gist of this. Also, hey Nikolai, thank you so very much for the host. I just noticed the alert box is behind other stuff, it should be on top of everything else. How weird. And also, hello Zach, welcome to the stream, how are you today? This early in the morning. So, as you guys are possibly well aware, Twitch has some emotes which you guys can use if you are subwoofers. But I'm not very pleased with the way the emotes currently look. Just so you guys can know. Well then. Oh, Twitch. So if you are a $5 subwoofer, you can have this emote right here. That thumbs up me. If you are a $10 subwoofer, you can have this emote of me being grumpy. And if you're a $25 subwoofer, which is like ludicrous, but if you are, you get this emote here of me having no idea. Actually, that one doesn't seem to work. What's up with it? Oh yeah, I deleted it. Oh. Dumbo me. Anyway, there's those three levels of subwoofing you can do, and each level has an emote. And as you can see there in the chat, they're extremely small, and they've been around for some months. And I'm not very sure I enjoyed them. just for a comparison. they are already looking pretty dang small there. And here in the picture you can see it's not that small. But this little box here on the side, let me find it here on the thingy. So this little box here is that ludicrously small 112 pixels. Pixels, it's a PX. Come on, dog, you can write. It's a 112 pixels tall and wide, because it's a square. And this is 500 pixels for comparison. So if I have my canvas at 100% size, 500 pixels looks pretty good. Looks big. 112 doesn't look that good. And let me go and open up. Oh, come on. Oh, Twitch. And all the other things. Okay, I don't know what's what. I will need these layers, I'll need to copy them. And then go on another layer entirely to do this. So, this here is the pictures, the illustration. Let's small down to 112. By the way, I'm doing a very rough approximation here. It's not gonna look this bad. It'll be more evenly cropped. But anyway, if I'm having my canvas at 100% size, 500 pixels looks pretty dang good. 112 doesn't look that good anymore. Very small, and there's a lot of details here and there that are missing and are not very good. Some things have already been lost, you can't see them very well. But for all intents and purposes, it still works. But now let's do another experiment. It's a very quick one. This is another canvas I have. This canvas is currently 112. Let's put this canvas at 100% size and change the resolution of the picture to a very small value, say something like 30 pixels tall, 30 pixels wide. It's very small, but it's more or less the size that something would show up in the Twitch chat. Actually, 25 pixels is more closely to what it would look like. So this is how it's gonna look like, pretty much. The canvas is at 100% size, which means it's showing in real size. It's not bigger nor smaller. It's exactly 25 pixels. In my 1080 screen, in your guys's, I think you guys are watching it at 720 resolution, so it's probably smaller. But still, it looks ridiculously small. It's hard, extremely hard to understand what's going on. Not entirely sure if it is actually 25 pixels tall that Twitch would recommend. Actually, no, it's 28. I was wrong. I was off by like 3 pixels. So let's go back here. Let's go to edit, change image resolution, 28 pixels wide and tall. So this is more or less how this whole thing is gonna look. And you can see, it's ridiculously small. Even if I zoom up, you already have some loss of resolution and details. It's really not pleasant to look at. So the current emote I had is already pretty small, but there's a lot of details missed, because you can pretty well see things. I made this emote, my current emote, like 5 months ago. They're good, but I'm not entirely pleased with them, so I was trying to change my emotes, I'm making new ones. So with this one here, I have bolder lines for the eyes, the face, for everything. I have bolder lines, which will show better when reduced to a small size. And I have the hand in front of the character now, with the thumbs up. And I threw in a very bold white outline here to really separate the thumbs up from the character, so you can really see it all together. I don't know how good it works, but I feel like it's gonna be better than the current emote I have on the channel. Kaze, say nice emote, thank you Kaze. Zach, you asked that small. Yeah, it is that small. For some reason, the Twitch emotes, they are extremely small. I don't know why. And also, Iruga, hello and welcome to the stream. How are you doing today? How is everybody doing today, by the way? Forgot to ask most of you. So, this is my Twitch emote, the $5 one. And then I have some other ideas. I have this one here, a Grump Me, just to override the previous Grump emote. As you can see, it suffers from the same problem. Since it's gonna become so small, I decided not to have an entire face here, but instead zoom in on the most important aspects, which is the narrowed eyes, the frowned forehead, and the displeased mouth. Also, this one I haven't finished doing yet, hence it doesn't have a finished version, it's just a sketch still. And then I have my $25 level emote. I don't expect anybody to get the $25 emote, but it exists, which is this one here. It's a little doggo of despair. I pretty much like this one, and I feel it overrides the no idea much better. Let's see if I can find it, just so you guys can compare. And also, Kaze, you say that this face is gold. Well, thank you, Kaze. I think this is it. Let me open up the old emotes so you guys can see it. There we go. So these were my previous emotes. They are extremely big here in comparison. So this used to be my my $5 emote. It's the thumbs up. This used to be my $10 emote, which is the Grump Me, and this is $25 emote, which was the no idea. By the way, here the hash, the asterisk, no idea asterisk, is very readable. But when it was this small, you couldn't even tell what it was. So I decided that if you want to have text show up in your emotes, the text has to be like half the size of the entire thing. Also, another thing I realized is that since you lose so many details, there's a lot of nuances you have you need to have here and there. First off is that here I threw in some shades. Those shades are extremely bad because they you add even more detail and it looks beautiful, but when you zoom out it just adds to the confusion. So if you have don't have shade, you have less colors, and with less colors it's easier to distinguish between areas and places and stuff. Another thing I realized is that these colors I have going, even though they are more or less my official colors, they blend extremely badly. So there you go, this is the color of the darker fur, the normal fur, the lighter fur, and the eyes. If I go on Clip Studio or Photoshop, whichever program you use, draw in a black box on another layer and then use the color mode layer effect to throw in color, you can see they're pretty close to one another. in value. Like the yellow and the orange, they almost blend. It's not a very good color scheme. It is concise, but it's not very good. It's easy to confuse things. Oh yeah, I also forgot the color of the beard. If you add that on top of everything else, this is the beard, by the way. And if you add the color layer, you can see from a distance you can barely tell things apart. So with these switcher modes here, I decided to go on another path. I decided to change the colors, make them more and have their values all over the place, so it makes it easier for people to tell them apart. So let's do the same thing. Let's throw in a black box here and throw in the color multiplier over this. So as you can see, it's easier to tell those colors apart, close up or from a distance. I mean, it's kind of hard to see nonetheless, but still, the difference between the colors themselves is more pronounced than it was over here. And that helps with being able to identify what is going on from a distance. And that's what is important here. You have to be able to tell from a distance what is what. So that's about it. That's what I wanted to show you guys. And also, not only that, but here on the side, you can see we have this very, very nice chapel doggo here. And this is gonna be the subscriber badges. You can see that currently anybody who is a subscriber, or as I like to call you guys, subwoofers, you have a star beside your name. This star means that you are a subscriber to my channel, and that means you are donating money to the channel and enjoying other benefits. So what happens with Twitch is that if you're an affiliate, which is what I am, you get so all these nice cool things. You get emotes, you get to have subscribers, you get bits enabled, a lot of things. You get them, they are enabled for your channel if you are an affiliate. But there's some things that they only allow partners to do. Partners, they are more or less the bigger affiliates. They are people who have a much bigger viewership. Because almost anybody can become an affiliate. So long as you dedicate yourself to streaming, you can become an affiliate pretty easily. I mean, within a couple of months, you can become an affiliate. But to become a partner, you have to stream very constantly. You have to stream for a long time. And on top of it all, you need to have an average of 75 viewers per stream. So, say, if during a day I stream for like 4 hours, but during only 1 hour my get like 100 viewers, but the entire stream I had like 10 viewers, my average is gonna be like 50 or even less. So to have a big average, the channel needs to grow extremely, and that's gonna take some time, and even I know it's gonna take several months or years. But anyway, until then, the custom subscriber badges was reserved for partners, but now they're coming to affiliates as well. So I decided to go and make my own affiliated, my own subscriber badge for when it comes out for the. When it comes out later this month for us, for you guys. Zach, it's a nice doggo icon. Why, thank you. This one is gonna be even smaller. And who gonna say looks like he's missing a paw? Yeah, it kinda looks. There's just a leg here. I used the reference, and the picture was kind of... The picture itself already looked like this, so I went and added stuff on my own. I added this little nuanced part here to give it a look like there's another little leg behind it, and they are coinciding pretty closely. Also, Kaze, this song, this anime, so good, but so cringy too. But anyway, the subwoofer badges, subscriber badges, they have a little something else going on with them. This extra something else is that you get a subscriber badge for several points during your subscription. You get them for subscribing normally, and then after 3 months it upgrades, and then after 6 months it upgrades again, after 1 year it becomes a different badge, after 2 years it becomes different, after 3 years it becomes different, 4 years, 5 years, and so on. And Twitch asks you to upload badges for different months. So what I did here is come up with this little drawing here, a little vector of a chapel, and then change the color scheme to kinda match my own. And then this is the normal, the 1 month subwoofer. Zach, you said wrong song. I think you can type in exclamation mark wrong song, and Goodbye Bot will remove the wrong song. Yeah. To make these nuanced versions for the other months, what I'm gonna do is throw in this kind of colorized effect onto the layer. So this is the 3 month subwoofer badge. This is gonna be the 6 months, it's gonna go through this spectrum of colors. And this red-ish here is gonna be the 1 year. The green one is gonna be... Well, it's gonna be 3 years, but I decided to change it to 2 years. Because... Since my character is already yellow by itself... throwing a yellow colorized doesn't work very well. So what I decided to do is throw a yellow on this side and a reddish on this side, so it looks more like golden. And then the 4-year-old has more colors. It's this color scheme pretty much. It's yellows, then some reds, then some blacks. It does that. And finally, for 5 years, if somebody decides to reach that long amount of subwoofing to me, they get the rainbow doggo. Look at that. So rainbow. I really have no idea who will go for 5 years, but if you decide to go for 5 years, you will get the rainbow doggo. And just thinking about it, it's extremely fun. I don't like this idea. And also, hello Ness Husky, welcome to the stream. How are you doing today, buddy? And also, Wolf Morning to you. And Ness Husky, thank you for following me on Twitch. Super duper appreciate it. And welcome to the pack. Iruga, you say that gay rainbow doggo is best doggo. Oh yes, it is. Don't take 5 years for anybody to have this, and it's gonna take forever. But nonetheless, if that ever happens, this is what it's gonna look like. I'm still working some kinks into this thing, like... I'm intending for this one because this colorized, it also changes the color of the outline. Kinda looks weird seeing this from a distance, so I'm thinking of applying this colorized effect only to the colors, not to the layer outline, or maybe have another color for the outlines and do so many different things here and there. But nonetheless, these are gonna be my new Twitch emotes, the $5, the $10, or the $25 emotes, and these are gonna be the subwoofer badges. If you guys decided by whatever reason I'm worth a subwoofer. What do you know? Clip Studio crashed slightly. Ness Husky, you found me on Kaboid Discord and decided to check my channel out. Why, thank you. You're welcome. Which reminds me. I don't think there's enough people here. But Kuboy Fox is another lovely streamer. He's been playing all sorts of nice games lately. Last time I checked, he was playing GTA 5. I don't know when that was. But nonetheless, Kuboy is an awesome dude and you should check him out. So these are gonna be it. They're gonna be introduced into the stream eventually. I don't know when. I'm still gonna have to work on these emotes, on this sub badge. My off time. I'm not gonna be working on them during the stream, but I'm gonna be working on them eventually. And someday they will be coming. Still this month though. But I hope you guys like them. The new emotes and the new sub badges. Theoretically, I don't know if this is gonna be a thing too, but for what's it called? You guys also get a badge if you donate bits, and for each amount of bits you donate, you get a different badge. And theoretically, you can customize those too, but I think that's gonna still gonna be a thing for partners. Still, it's not gonna be for. Enabled for affiliates, which kind of sucks, but then again, Beats, they have many more versions. It's not like 8 versions, it's like 25 or so. It's really crazy. But anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this, and I'll keep working on them, and you can check out the progress on the Discord. I'll be posting it all up there as well. Ness Husky, I need that rainbow dog badge, matches you perfectly. Okay, doggo. Yeah, I'm still not sure about the way the rainbow works, but it's definitely gonna be a rainbow. And everybody's gonna need one of those. Ruby say Clip Studio, more like Whip Studio. Kazi say cute doggo. Thank you, Kazi. Mercat, hello. Welcome to the stream. How I'm doing today? I'm doing good. I woke up like 1 hour ago and I'm already doing crazy things. Okay, enough with the Twitch emotes and whatnot. Let's work. That's what we came here to do today. So this is yesterday comic page. Page number 9. Let's open up the preview here in the corner. So I was working on this page yesterday. You can see I left off a lot of things undone. I didn't finish Gavin's pose, now I have, and I didn't do these last panels, now I have. So it's done now, this page. It's entirely done, more or less, and we can move on to the next page, which I began working on already yesterday. But because it required me to sketch up backgrounds, I was like, fuck it, I'm gonna do that later, tomorrow or so. And then I started to work on the badges and notes. But yeah, I'm doing pretty good. I woke up not long ago, I'm still having my coffee, and I'm already streaming. But how about you, Mercat? How are you doing? Yurugi, you scream bolt daddy. Zach, good boy bot isn't working well. He's kinda iffy here and there. But there's a even bigger chance that he will not be able to find your song if you throw in the link with a YouTube link with more things to it, like if you throw a YouTube link with that, they're like, start from this point or within this playlist, the chances of it working are much smaller. So there's that. But if GoodboyBot doesn't request your song, just try again. He takes a while to get working. Ness, I just woke up and I need to make coffee. Well, go make some coffee then. You need that delicious juice to get up. And also, I hadn't realized before, but holy shit, Kaze, you had some woof to the channel during the off hours when the stream wasn't going on. So thank you so very much, Kaze, for that delicious sub woof. In fact, let me go and replay that little notification just for you, Kaze. Just for you, that little subwoof notification. There you go, Kaze, my newest subwoofer. Welcome to the subwoofing pack. And thank you so very much for subwoofing, Kaze. And look at that, you dealt some damage to Bones. Or the young Bonesy. And also, good morning, Bones. How are you doing today? Welcome to the stream. And also, Ness, how would you rather me call you, Ness or Ness Husky? So, this is page 9. It's done already. I'm gonna keep working on this after I have more pages sketched. So the next page we have to sketch is page number 10, and page number 10 has a problem, a gigantic problem. It has backgrounds, holy shit, background, look at this. I think I need to do some explaining on this page before we can properly begin working on this one. Let me show you another preview here. So what's up with page number 10? First we have this. It's a bus. It's stopping on a whatever kind of bus stop this place has. And then down comes a passenger, which is Nathan. It's not a metropolitan bus, it's one of those buses that go between cities and for people who wanna travel afar. So it's stopping near a petrol station or another landmark or sign, I don't know what yet, but I want to fill this area here with something that kind of shows what city that is. And then here we have Nathan looking back at his home with a little smile on his face. He looks too exaggerated, it's not gonna be this big of a smile, as he reminds his childhood hometown. And the bus keeps going away into the distance, and then Nathan goes after. He goes somewhere. I thought I'm making him go in this direction, but I feel like maybe I have to flip this one here. So the bus is going one way, and Nathan is going back the other way. Kinda makes a little bit more sense. Although it's extra work, so I don't even know how I'm gonna do this. But yeah, this page is like 90% background and very little percent characters. So this is gonna be the shitty part about this one. Bones, you are hurt. You are hurt because Kaze gunned on you a whooping. And Irube said the only thing that you hate about Telegram is that you can't keep watching stuff if you want to read / answer stuff there. Why is that? Oh, you're doing stuff on your cell phone. You're watching and talking on your cell phone, I suppose. Bounces. Wait, what, Kaze, why? Ness, most people call you Ness, but it doesn't matter to you. Okay then, I will call you either, whichever my mind goes with at the time. Bones, you said that you are weak and hurting, you need healings. Well, that really sucks, Bones, you certainly do need the healings, but if anybody else would like to go and swipe that stream boss status, now's the time when Bones is crippled and weak. Now is the time for the final blow. Meruga, I need healing is a phrase of forever, I'll be forever afraid of hearing again. Why is that? And as Husky, you don't know why you're just in an electro swing mood. Well, feel free to request electro swing songs then. Meruga, you're always support main in any game you play. Kaze, you can't heal what's not broken. Of course you can! I never played Team Fortress 2 when did them overhealing on what's it called again? Oh, the big Russian dude. I forgot what his is. Anyway, enough laughing about. Let's get you working. And not only that, but I forgot to ask, but how are all of you doing? I'm not gonna ask individually because I'm not entirely sure who asked this already, true or not. But if you guys would, if you like sharing anything about your days, about how is it going so far, feel free to. How are you guys doing? Also, Bones, how was your yesterday? After I finished my stream yesterday, I looked up about the furry streamers in the community and, I mean, to see who was streaming. What do you know? Found a streamer was already who I already had streamed in the past, one Incragator. And I raided him and it was fun, he was playing Puyo Puyo Tetris. Then after a while I joined in and got to play some matches of Puyo Puyo Tetris with them. Actually just Tetris, I don't know how to play Puyo. We got to play some we got to play some together, me, him and other dudes who had joined in as well. It was amazing fun, but Bones said that you guys had already known each other. Actually, Inkra said that he knew you since the 2008. That's a long time. It's more or less when I joined the fandom as well. So that's so you have been around for very long and you have met a lot of people. And it was amazing to see you guys reunite like that, like randomly over Twitch of all places. Nonetheless, I hope it was a nice little reunion you and him had, if you guys had a reunion. But I hope it was fun for you. Because for me it definitely was fun joining in and playing some Tetris. Also, you probably will notice that I'm not following so super closely the sketch I have in the background. The sketch I did on paper. And that is because that sketch I did on paper I did with a pen instead of using a pencil. I use a pen to make sure my sketching is done quickly because I don't want to ponder I don't want to take long when I'm doing these sketches on paper. I want it to be done as fast as possible because all I need is the layout. I don't need any accuracy on it. I just need to find out what's the best pose and what's the best expression and where characters will fit. But if it looks bad, that's no problem. I will be doing another sketch afterwards, but digitally, which is this one I'm doing right now. Because of that, I don't go for accuracy when I'm doing the sketch on the paper. So if it sucks, it's alright. And hence why I'm not following it so closely. Yuruga, you said Medic over Healing Heavy is OP. I wouldn't know. I actually never played too much Team Fortress. Zach, big Russian dude in TF2, the character's quote-unquote name is Heavy. And Bones, you say Inkra, longtime friend. Zach, you made Amuse, Push, and Sushi in Cooking Clash today. Teacher made it look so easy. I don't even know what that is. I mean, the amuse-bouche. I don't know what I know more or less what sushi is, but not that first one. What is it? What sort of crazy food is that? Sounds fancy, by the way. Bone says, seriously, Tetris is love, and you're an old dog. Yeah, I know. You're extremely old, Bones. Don't mind me asking, how exactly old are you? And I mean, if I were to guess, I would guess like 27, 29. Iruka's Doggo and Tetris reminds you of stuff. Good times, in fact. Have we ever played Tetris? I don't remember that. I really do not remember having played Tetris with you. But then again, knowing myself, I don't doubt that it happened. Back in the day, I was really into Tetris, and whoever had just an inkling of goodwill, I would push them into playing Tetris with me. So, I really don't doubt that it happened. Also, Ness, the song reminds me of the first level of, what's it called again? That cooking game. What was it again? This little game when you can play with four people and you play like four people and you are walking around the kitchen and you have to keep chopping food, putting into buckets, the pans, and cooking it up and doing. And then that over and over. I don't remember the name of that game. Yes, Overcooked. Thank you, Iruga. This song reminds me of the first level song for Overcooked. Kind of follows the same rhythm. It's a very lovely song. And what I like the most is that when the time is running out, that song picks up pace and it gets really faster and it's amazing. But there's another electro swing music that I heard a long time ago, and I always forget what it's called, but I love that song. I'll never find it again, but I love that song, whatever that song was. Kaze, you joined like 9 months ago in the fandom. That's not a whole lot of time, Kaze. You're a very young boy. Very young furry boy. Awesome. Goodbye, bot. Would you please? Oh, good boy, bot. Why do I keep using you? Bones, you said that you are age 33. That's still very young, truly. Zach, amuse bouche is French for mouth pleaser. Might have to Google what it is. I'll Google it eventually. Ruge said we played over there on DS. Yeah, that's what I thought. I don't remember. But probably did. Bones, Cookie Mama, no, it was overcooked, the game. Nez, love Electro Swing ever since EntroCon 2016. Oh, you lucky Americans who can go to cons that easily. I mean, I'm assuming you're American, but it's possible that you're not American. It's possible that you're like all the way from Indonesia and decided to travel. Who knows? Do you remember like any key word from the song? More or less. Kinda hard to go over it with this current song playing in the background. It was like it was like a lady singing. I don't remember the lyrics at all. All that I remember is that it was something from the back to the left, and then it went to a part where she wasn't singing any lyrics. It was just like that's more or less how it went. I really don't know what to look for lyric wise. But I heard that song playing on the radio once and I was like, oh, that's a cool song, I like that song. It sounds awesome. You could try to find it. And you do get this written reminds you of Caravan Palace. Yes, you live 6 hours from the con. Well, 6 hours is not too long, depending on how you go. And yes, you are American, you want to say it's Caravan Palace, Lawn Digger. No, it's not. Actually, I do think I remember a place I posted it at. Like, I do remember going to a place once when people were talking about the song. And I said, hey, is this the song? And then I threw it into a... I threw it there. I wonder, how do I search for... Oh, here we go. Aha! And I didn't post the link, I posted the name. It's Caro Emerald Back It Up. There we go. I'm gonna request it. I have the weirdest sort of memory, I swear. Oh, I like the song. Oh, those Beat Saber days. I didn't even knew this song was in like around in YouTube, but I should have guessed it was. I don't know why I'm surprised by this. I mean, everything's on YouTube nowadays. Which reminds me, I have to go and play play Beat Saber again on the stream. Possibly I should go back and mod the game, try some new songs or maybe some other different things. And practice a lot. So I can play those songs on expert instead of show up, play like 3 songs and start to wheeze and collapse on the floor. Nobody would want a repeat of that. Yeah, it wasn't Caravan Palace, Lone Digger, but you can re-request that song if you'd like. I don't mind it. Also, holy shit, how are you even being able to request this many songs? Theoretically, there's a... You need Good Boy Pounds to request songs, and since you just showed up, I don't know how you have enough GBP to be requesting this many songs. Saber is like the weirdest sort of game because it's supposed to be a rhythm game, and it is. But a rhythm game akin to Dance Dance Revolution or Pump It Up. However, it has one single composer, and that's like a really iffy way of doing a rhythm game. If you want to do a rhythm game, you probably don't want to go about it with just one single musician on your team. You probably want more people about and with you. The design is too big. Let's reduce its size a little bit. Fix it up in other ways. Oh no. Why do you have such weird eyes, Nathan? What have you done with your life? What sort of things have been going through to get such weirdly shaped eyes, Nathan? This is not normal. You can look all over the internet, all over the world. You will never find another tiger boy with eyes as weird as yours. Oh, poor Nathan. Nathan is weird as a whole, actually. Anyway. Bones, you say, OMG, Doug, you almost died. # Beat Saber. I wouldn't say I almost died. I would say that I had was very close to meeting my maker. But now that I die, I would have died if I kept going on. I would probably just collapse. For a little bit and then get back up. Who knows? But that's the thing I actually wondered. Weird as it sound, I wonder what would happen if I were to be playing some VR games and suddenly I collapse. Like, literally, I pass out on the stream. What would happen? What would people do? Would they be like, well then, let's wait for a host to get back online. And simply wait until I have convulsions on the floor, or... What length would people go to make sure I'm alright and whatnot. Because theoretically nobody knows where I live. So if I were to have an actual seizure or whatever, nobody would be able to do anything. So that's a more or less dangerous thought. So maybe you're right, Bones. Maybe I should take it easy when I'm playing in VR games. Maybe I should not overdo it and ensure that kind of situation will never come to pass. By the way, Iruga, when we played Tetris on the DS, as you claim we did, how was it? Because I'd suppose that if you got to play some Tetris on the DS, I'd try to teach you how to set up Tetris's and how to play Tetris Battle, competitive Tetris. And I tried to teach you some tricks here and there. I would suppose that happened, but I don't know. Maybe I was an asshole and said, ha 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 ha, I'm gonna just keep beating your ass and never gonna teach you how to do things right. So I don't know. Nas said you'd rather not, you have heard it way too many times, you honestly have no idea. Magic, you guess. Maybe. Maybe you have the magic of them doggos. Everybody knows doggos are magical beings, full of surprises and nice things going on with them. Nobody knows why doggos exists, but everybody can agree the doggos are magnificent and are amazing. Oh, Nathan, how does your muzzle go again? I don't remember. Oh, it's gonna look like that. Kazi, that would be scary. Yes, it would. Naz is saying not just that. Imagine how fucked up your brain would be if you did pass out in the VR headset and on the first thing you see is the VR world. Oh yeah. Oh yeah, that would be really fucked up. Like, extremely scary. And could literally traumatize a person. Or a doggo, who knows. But yeah, I think that the first thing ever, if I were to do a... Well, if I were to pass out during the stream, not that that'll happen, because I try to be mindful of my limits as a living being. If I were to pass out on the stream, I would assume that some of you would have the thought of going into Discord and telling Garano about what happened. Like, I was watching Doug's stream and suddenly he passed out. He would go and take some action. That's what I assume you guys would do, but hopefully that'll never need to become a thing, because hopefully I'll never collapse on the stream and I'll never pass out. In fact, I never have passed out in my life. There's a lot of people I know who have actually passed out. My sister has passed out multiple times during her life. Although I think I got very near passing out a couple of times, but I never really did pass out, and I don't even know what triggered it, because I'm not what you would call a person who doesn't eat up. Like, My sister, she passed out because she had a very, very bad nutrition. I, on the other hand, I'm a fat doggo. I don't. If I pass out, it's not because I'm underfed. And this is the song I was talking about. So the one time I almost passed out, I almost passed out was when I was on the train going anywhere. It was not a rush hour, so the train was mostly empty, but I was standing up nonetheless and reading a book. Every time I almost passed out, that was how it went. This is the song, this is the part. This is not even lyrics, it's just a... Well, this is lyrics, but this part here is not. But anyway, I think that's what Trigger did. If I'm riding a train, because it's going fast, but if you look outside the windows, it's moving really fast, but the train's not shaking or anything. So I guess that your brain is kind of tricked a little bit. And you're also trying to focus on a book in front of you and read it. Every single time I felt like super dizzy, felt really bad, felt like I was gonna throw up or whatever, pass out on the floor. I don't even know how to describe it. I just know that I felt extremely bad and extremely weird, and it was always like that on a train, standing up. The train was empty, and I was reading a book. I did do many other different things, like the train was empty but I was sitting down, so it didn't trigger that. I was standing up and reading a book, but the train was full of people, so I was actually kind of pressed against other people, and that didn't trigger it either as well. And yeah, simply riding on the train and not reading books also don't trigger. I guess it's that particular set of circumstances. And even then, it doesn't seem like it's always, every single time that happens. So that's what bamboozles me the most. But anyway. Sam, you say morning to you all. Well, woof morning to you, Sam. Welcome to the stream. What are you doing today? Are you still home from being sick? Or have your school vacations started already? I don't even know. Zack, in Japan, a doggo god is an evil entity. He was at war with the Foxo god. Really? But doggos are so good. They're so nice and so dang good. Oh, those Japanese, they don't know what's up. Samuel asks, who's with us? A lot of people. Don't wanna go and read up any names because I'm scared the people who are lurking. But there are some people who are here with us and partaking in the chat, and there are some people who are just lurking. But nonetheless, all of those people are extremely good boys and girls. And also we have Kazi. Kazi, say hello to Sam. Oh, you already did. What do I know? Naz is with us as well. Naz is new here. This is his first time he's here, I think. He's a very young, delicious boy. According to him, he's a skinny/muscular doggo, and he's here to grace us with his canine presence. And not only that, but he has been requesting all sorts of songs. I mean, all sorts of songs. So long as the only sword you are counting is Electro Swing. But he has been requesting songs, and that's good. This reminds me of another group too, though. I don't remember what they are called, nor what their songs are called. But it was this old group that made songs like this. I think one of their songs is called I Love the Rain. I'm not entirely sure though. Kaz, you said you have once collapsed. After hitting a door, then a wall, finally the corner of the desk in a row. Holy shit. How did that even happen, Kaz? But apparently, you don't collapse often, but when you do, you really commit to it. Sam, you had a nightmare and you're in the middle of your vacation. How long is it gonna be for? Is it gonna be just a couple of weeks or it's gonna be the entire month? I do remember that when I was in, I think, elementary school or middle school, our winter vacations were like 4 weeks. But I almost sneezed. When I was in high school, the winter vacations became only like couple of weeks, if I'm not mistaken. They were extremely short. And now, good night. The end of a perfect evening. That reminds me as well that the lately, I don't know who, released a new Pokemon game on the Android, Pokemon Quest. And I've played it a little bit, it's kind of fun, it's kind of cute, and all that. But it suffers from all the same evils that most mobile games suffer nowadays. And it kind of pad your progress in a way, in a very, way. Like, now you need microtransactions if you want to be able to keep playing this game and other ways to pad your progress. And that made me think, maybe I should go and play one of the newest Pokemons. But, and do a thing I always wanted to do but I never got around to do, which is the Nuzlocke Challenge. For those of you who are unaware of what the Nuzlocke Challenge is, the idea behind it is that the Nuzlocke Challenge is that you get to play Pokemon normally, but if a Pokemon faints, you consider it dead and you release it into the wild. So the idea is you can't never let your Pokemon faint. If they faint, it's it. That's it for that Pokemon forever. So I have to... Yep. So I have to be extra careful of all Pokemons. That's the gist of the Nuzlocke Challenge. And it sounds like a lovely idea. play Pokemon like that, kind of like a roguelike survival shenanigan. Sam, so you're here to try and forget the nightmare. Well, let's talk about other things. Kansas says you know me. Of course I do. You've been here for quite some time. Sam, you say saudações, Ness. Ness, you say you can change the genre. Pop, you have songs for every genre. Oh, you can always request video game soundtracks. I love them. Love me some good old OSTs from classics and new games alike. The song that Zach has requested, this one that was playing until now, was pretty amazing. I don't even know what it was from or for, but I liked it. Okay, now Nathan's expression looks more dismayed. A little more of a glint of longing. Kaze, it was being pushed into the corner behind the door, and your friends are squooshing you after they stopped playing around between Aster's guy. From behind the door, kicks it. It hits your head, and the head hits the wall. You fall slowly for your head. Fall slowly for your head to hit the corner of the desk. Oh my, that sounds awful. Why in the world were they even doing that to you, Kaze? That doesn't sound like a nice thing to be doing to a young Kaze boy like you. So, it either makes me think that either your friends are not very nice and they're more or less were bullying you, or you did something very bad to deserve that. Very, very, very bad. And then, as you say, also Sam, the Zidane Queen is still. Well, welcome to our little canine pack, Ness. Ness, okay, that's enough. Let's just swing. Time for some chiptune. Our chiptunes are fun. It wasn't actually an entire Spotify playlist of chiptunes and MIDI versions of classical songs. It was amazing. And Ness, is this better? I like it. So there's some fun little songs. And Kaze, we play rough. Oh my. Well, there's playing rough and there's playing until one of your friend collapses. Which is like a level above rough. It's like one speed away from being an entirely different game and being like murder or something else. But luckily you survived. So hooray for that. By the way, Kaze, I haven't done that yet, but recently I don't remember when, yesterday I think. I was checking your Furry Affinity account to see your comic. Wow, you have 4 pages up already. It's looking pretty dang good, if I might say so. However, there's a lot of little tidbits here and there that I would complain or criticize and tell you to improve upon, but those pages are up already, so there's very little we can do about that. Actually, we can. But, eh. Never mind. The only thing I would like to tell you is that I have no idea how you're doing the lettering, but you should always try to center the text within the balloon. The text feel like it doesn't feel centralized with the balloon, and that might not seem like a lot, but it is extremely distracting. And doesn't look good, so change that, cousin. I mean, don't change that, but in the next few pages, be mindful of that. But other than that, I'm intrigued to see what's up with this new comic of yours. New, quote-unquote. It's not like you're posting like one page a month. But still, it's fun to see that you're doing progress with your comic and your comicking endeavors. Sam, you're playing a Rage game now. What game are you playing? Kaze, they freaked out. Oh yeah, I'd imagine. If me and my friends were playing, suddenly one of us were to do something and make a friend of ours pass out, we would freak out as well. In fact, once I caused a friend of mine to go to the hospital, more or less, wasn't anything serious, but it could have been, but it wasn't, so hooray. And one time we broke one of my friend's couch. We broke their, when we were playing at their house, and we broke the couch. I think we were playing soccer. I mean, on the video games, we were playing soccer, and then one of the players in the game made some kind of weird movement with their legs, and we tried to mimic over the couch, and we ended up breaking it. And then we were like, "Oh shit!" But again, breaking a couch is nothing compared to breaking your friend's head. So. Never mind. Naz, you say play Getting Over It with Benefati. And Sammy already did. And Ghost, you know, really never heard of that. Me neither. And also, hello there, Pixel Squid. What is up with you, friend? How are you doing today in this comic book art Tuesday? Tuesday. I don't know if you guys noticed this by now, but I still get confused between Tuesdays and Thursdays. The T U and T H days. And as you made by the same people that made Getting Over It, really? Oh no. Those rage inducing games. Kaze, you say, yeah, funny story. You intended and did drew a small chibi face of both you and the teacher, and you finished them. After you finished them, the PS crashed. You had madam said, forget it. Oh no. Poor Kaze. That's why we always save. And that's why we don't use Photoshop. Because Photoshop crashes like a... It crashes like it's a stuntman driving a car. You might, but if it were me, you would not be using Photoshop for anything remotely serious. Instead, you would be using Clip Studio Paint, because it's lovely and doesn't crash. That one time I said it didn't crash, it was actually auto-saving my files. Because Clip Studio has a built-in function that every now and then it saves everything that I'm doing to make sure that if something happens, I won't lose my files. But to do that, it kind of stops the program for a little while and it feels like it crashed, but it didn't, it's just saving the files. Whereas Photoshop, no, it actually crashes. It doesn't save any files. It crashes and you lose your progress entirely. So there is that. And Sam, you're playing Yandere Evil.exe. Never heard of that. And also, Sam, you play some the weirdest kind of games. NES. So do you guys hear in the NVIDIA's next graphics card is gonna be the GTX 1180. I have heard of that, more or less. I did hear that they were planning to come up with a new series of cards, but I wasn't really following it up. I mean, I heard the news, but I didn't went much after it, because a while ago, I don't remember when, I said, you know what, there's this new game that not everybody is super into playing, but just released, and I really want to play it. That game was Fallout 4. I played it, and I had to play on the lowest of settings, and it was fun. I could play it. But I thought, maybe you need a graphics card upgrade. But I just missed it. I kept playing my Fallout 4. Then, a few months later, another small game was released. Maybe you guys have never heard of that game. And if you haven't, I won't fault you for that. But it released. And I wanted to play it. That game was Mass Effect Andromeda. And it released. And as soon as I got it, I could not, for the life of me, run it at a higher resolution than 720p. And if you have a big monitor, 720p is... it's not a resolution you would like to play a game at. Be it windowed mode or be it full screen, because windowed mode is an extremely small window, and if it is full screen, it will look super pixelated. So either way, it's bad. So I decided, you know what, I really want to play this game, it looks awesome, and I want to be able to enjoy this. So I'm gonna buy a new graphics card, and then I bought a GTX 1070. It was expensive, I was still paying it for like a few months ago. I was still paying for that graphics card, if I'm not still paying for it, I don't know. But anyway, I bought it like a year ago, and it took me months to pay it off. But I just changed the graphics card, I'm not planning to buy another one anytime soon. But what I do actually intend to do is buy a new processor. However, to buy a new processor, I will need to buy a new motherboard, because every new processor, it has a different socket. Instead of being the 1150, it's the 1151. So I need to buy a new motherboard if I want to buy a new processor. And it's never a smooth process changing your motherboard and processor and everything else. There's so many things involved in that. So I'm still waiting, saving up some money to be able to do that. So probably only next year. But that's a thing I do intend to do. Because for gaming, you don't need a very powerful processor. But for doing art and this stuff, I kinda do want a good processor. And also, all the RAM memory you can have. You can never have too much RAM memory, I don't think. So those are the things I intend to do, not buy a new graphics card, but definitely a new processor. in a distant, not so distant future. So Nathan, that hand of yours is too small, you need bigger hands. What do you think you're gonna be doing with those small hands of yours? Grabbing things we will not. Kaze, the last time it crashed was like 2 months ago. Still, last time Clip Studio crashed on me was never. So there you go. And as you have a GTX 1050 Ti overclocked edition, have yet to find a game that you can't play at 60 FPS. And you only trust asses for motherboards you refuse to buy from any other company. I don't even know what my motherboard is. I think it's either a Gigabyte motherboard. I actually haven't had much problem with motherboards. The last problem I had with a motherboard was that it fried because I dropped some water into it. But then again, that wasn't a problem with the motherboard itself, it was more so a problem with me and my very bad placement of things in the physical world. FIPS? Sorry, frames per second, FIPS. Yes, I do know that. FIPS are frames per second. I'm just being silly. In case you didn't notice, I'm a silly doggo, and I do silly things, and I say silly things, except when I don't. And I'm not saying silly things, I'm saying very hurtful things. But most of the time, I'm saying silly things. And there we have it. An Nathan boy looking into the distance with longing eyes of like, ah, I used to live here once. Oh, so these songs you guys have been requesting reminded me of another song. However, it's kinda hard to find it. Oh YouTube, why do you have to pick every single song and extend it to like hours? Well, there you have it. Have a go with this little song here. And then this other song here, I never heard this one before, I don't think. Because it's new as shit. It is, because it's a little fun song. A fun little song is what I mean to say. Oh, what do you know? Goodbye-bot didn't request one of the songs I tried. I told it to request. Oh, Goodbye-bot. You're such a silly bitch. Kaze, alright, you're gonna get a shower. We'll be watching, but one talk. How in the world are you gonna be watching a stream in the shower, Kaze? Oh, have a good one. And as you try to be a silly doggo, but sometimes it gets you in trouble. Oh no, how so? And Sam, you say that you cannot be silly. You have to be responsible all the time and also kind and understanding. That sounds like a very, very rough life we're leading, Sam. Actually, for the longest time, I used to be extremely silly. And do all sorts of silly things and say all sorts of sillier things. Except that... during a time... people were kinda having all sorts of bad situations going on with them. And they needed someone to be kinda serious about it. And I was all about being silly, being... being a little jokester me, and people were like, fuck off. And that's when I noticed that, oh no, not everybody will respond nicely to silliness. Maybe I need to cut it down a little bit. And then that happened. That was like way too long ago. Way too long ago. Okay, there I have it. So one thing I was thinking about this panel here, this deliciously small panel here, is that the bus is gonna be going that direction, and Nathan would also be going that same direction. So if I reuse the same background here, if I use the same background for this panel and this panel, I'm gonna be saving up time. But it kinda doesn't make a whole lot of sense for the bus to be going to that same direction and then Nathan goes after the bus. So why did he leave early? Doesn't make a whole lot of sense, but you know what? That's how buses work, that's how the buses I took work, so eh. And as you're gonna be a lurking doggo because I have some stuff to do, but you will still be watching. Oh, sure thing, Ness. Thank you so very much for being here, showing up, following, and being such a good sport and requesting so many good songs. Good luck with whatever it is that you're gonna be doing. Hope you have fun with it. Sam, say I see. Good luck, Ness. Aren't we all best doggos we are trying to be, except you, Sam. You're not a doggo, but you're still trying to be a good boy, so that counts. Sam, you said that you're lonely now, except for me, Mr. Douglas. Oh no. Oh, Sam. Seems like it's only you and I. I and you. So you said you're in a vacation from school endeavors. How long would that vacation of yours will be going for? I feel like I asked, but I don't think you got your answer. I don't know if you did answer and I didn't catch it, or if you didn't answer at all. But I'm wondering. For those of you who don't know what I'm doing here, I'm using perspective division to make sure I get this height of the bus here, then this is half height, and this is one quarter height. I think one quarter height is about a nice size for the wheels. This box here doesn't have like a... it doesn't have a very concise size, but heck it. It works. I like the way it is, so eh. Sam, your school only gives you 2 weeks of break, so on Sunday you will go back home. Oh, you're not home. Where in the world are you? Morning. And for arts, hello and welcome to the stream and channel and our lives, and thank you so very much for following me on Twitch, and also welcome to our Canani pack. How are you doing today? So this wheel might look a little small. I'm actually open up some bus references. Oh, I look for bus and the first thing it shows is cartoon buses. it's a travel bus.
No, not a metropolitan bus. I want a travel bus.
Those are pretty. Look smart. They look beautiful. Or not. I don't want anything too fancy. I want something that it's easy to draw. To illustrate. For arts, be right back, sure thing. Sam said that your father has a mind. You might draw today, even though you're not an artist. You don't have to be an artist to draw. If you want to draw, all you have to do is go and draw. Except if you want. If you want to be a professional illustrator, then yeah, you need to know how to draw. But as far as life goes, you don't need to be an expert in illustration to have fun with drawings. Okay, there's not a whole lot of perspective going on in there. But eh, it works. All I need is some rulers to help me get the size here, right? So this is the height of a bus. This bus in this example of ours. Let's see, let's do some perspective division here. Get a nice idea of how tall a wheel would be in an actual bus. Oh, it is actually 1/4 height. Okay. That's surprisingly pleasant. Okay, so 1/4 height for the bus wheel. Okay. And then the door isn't the entire bus, it's like 3/4 height for the door, I think. Looks like it, except that the front of the bus kind of bends a little bit forward. So there's that too. So 3/4 height, more or less around there. The front of the bus is gonna end here-ish. Let's do a curving. Now it looks more or less like a travel bus. Sam said that no, you respect artists and drawing, but you're not aiming to become an illustrator. That's why you respect me, Mr. Douglas. And Tiger asked, but do you enjoy it? Is it fun for you, Sam? Sam said that of course fine drawing relaxing, but you're much more of a writer. Oh. You could also go and write. If that's what you enjoy the most, maybe that's what you should be doing. Not only because you do enjoy it, but also because since it's a thing you enjoy so thoroughly, it will do you good to spend, to invest time into perfecting that craft, to making it better, into writing, because then all this time this bus kind of looks wrong, but it's probably my drawing. Because all this time you invest in drawing, you could be investing in writing, and then that'll help. Further down the line, when you're like, I don't know, 20 whatever years old, you're gonna see how it's gonna be useful to have started writing from an earlier age, rather than to decide to start it up when you're that old. In short, invest time in that which you enjoy doing. But said that you just don't aim to become an illustrator. And also, hello Tiger, welcome to the stream. How are you doing today? Or tonight? Or true afternoon? I don't know what time of the day it is for you. But how are you doing nonetheless? I hope you're doing good. Also, yes, I am curving the front of the bus because as we can see, buses make no freaking sense. They have a really weird shape. Actually, the front of the bus is gonna have this kind of shape. The back of the bus is gonna have it's kind of like here-ish. So this whole front here of the bus is kind of does this curve. It's kind of really boggling. It's really bamboozling. I'm trying to figure this one out. Because what is weird is that it curves not only like how can I show this? It doesn't curve just like this. It also curves like this. So there's a lot of curves to be working with here. To make this kind of shape here. And where do they even meet? It's weird as shit. That's what it is. But anyway. Where was I? Doing this thing over here. That kind of works, I guess. Because as we saw in that little reference picture, the upper part of the bus kinda further back than the lower part of the bus. So it's crazy is what it is. And also hello Chandler. Welcome to the stream. How are you doing today, buddy? Ladies and gentlemen, it's Chandler. One of the best boys, if not the bestest boy. Why is Chandler the best boy, you might ask? Well, because Chandler has been here since forever, and he's been a huge, huge supporter of all things beautiful and good. And by which I don't mean me, I mean the community we have going on, which is big and beautiful. Also, hello Chandler, welcome to the stream, how are you doing today? Chandler, it has been, you're doing great. Hey, thanks. Well, don't mention it. I hope you've been doing good. Oh no, this looks so crooked. Or does it? Oh yeah, it does. It's been forever since we last seen you. I mean, not truly forever, because we had seen you like last week, but still. You've become a busy boy. How's your work going? I hope you're enjoying it. You have been working, but you haven't been sharing much of it. I hope it's because you cannot share much of it because of confidentiality shenanigans, not because you secretly don't enjoy it. I hope you do enjoy your work. And this is the reason why I was working on this page yesterday and I decided to give it a break. Because doing backgrounds and doing mechanical objects like this, it's extremely boring in illustration. I mean, not boring, it's actually dope as shit. But it's complicated, and I don't... gonna not be the biggest enjoyer of drawing cars, vehicles, buses, and whatnot. If you wanna find a person who thoroughly enjoys doing this sort of thing, look for, what's it called again, Scott Robertson. That guy, he wrote several books on illustration. Technical illustration, rather. Yeah, more or less technical illustration. I don't know what kind of illustration it does. It's more of a... it doesn't draw a lot of character, that's for sure. It draws mostly vehicles and environments. He's really big into the perspectives and doing model cars, model planes, and stuff. He's amazing at it, but holy shit. Does it look complicated? Anyway, if you really want to get into drawing things in perspective like buses, vehicles, houses and whatnot, check out Scott Robertson. That guy is the bomb when it comes to this kind of stuff. Chandler, yes, you have been, work has been going great, but most of your business has been from you cleaning your apartment and being with your boyfriend for 2 days out of the week. Finally been able to make a sort of schedule, so you can actually start doing things you enjoy again, such as coming here. Aww. Do you enjoy coming here? That's amazing. Aww, Chandler. So glad to hear that. And you're always gonna be welcome here, you beautiful boy, you. And also, having some sort of routine of schedule is pretty good for the mind, knowing what you are more or less supposed to be doing each day, and yeah, it can help you give some sense of how things are going. I'm glad you found that. And other than that, we're always eager to hear more from you, Chandler, so whenever you can, make sure to stop by and give us a little brief hello. We all will be delighted to hear from you. By the way, I don't suppose you have, but I'm gonna ask nonetheless, have you gone to AntroCon, or have you been following up with that, or anything along that line of ways to spend time? Because I have been, not too much, but I have been on Twitter a little bit these last 2 days, and AntroCon has been the one thing I've been seeing, like, constantly and endlessly on the social media. So I wonder, I mean, I don't wonder, I know there's a lot of people doing all sorts of things there, and I wonder, are you one of them? Are you one of those congoers? Are you enjoying the foreign conventions? Also, this is a fancy bus, so it's gonna have a fancy ladder. And the door is gonna behave fancily, so instead of like curving to open or whatever, it kinda goes inside the wall. I feel like that's what buses door they do with these travel buses. It's not a very long travel bus, but it's a travel bus nonetheless, so please don't pay much mind to it. Eh, it works. It works like that. And a little railing, because of course those people getting in and out of the bus, they need something to hold on to. So they have a railing here. Chandler, say hashtag bless. You've never... never been to a furry con before. You've only been to two cons in your life, and both were general comic gaming kind of cons. I do enjoy cons very much. Well, lucky you, I never been to a furry con either. I have been to Comic Con. I think that's what it's called. And another anime convention that happened like in 2008. Which I remember very well. Because it was kind of odd, but also awesome. Because I do remember it was like my first convention ever, my sister took me there. And... my sister took me to that convention. And it was awesome, and when I came back home... there was this... sort of... gaming site I used to follow, and that gaming site had just released a new game on it. Back when I was deep into that deep piracy days of mine, and that game was Fallout 3, a game nobody had heard of for ages, and I played Fallout 3 and I was like, holy shit, this game is awesome. That's why I remember that so clearly. And so vividly. And Chandler, you ask, when did you become a humble partner, Doug? I don't know. It's been like 3 weeks, I think. Three weeks. Hasn't been that long. But then again, that's an awesome opportunity to explain once again, what is a humble partner? As you guys probably know, there's this... what is it? An organization, I think. Called Humble. I think it's called Humble. They sell games. They've started up all the way back in 2011, 2010, by doing the Humble Bundles, a little collectania of games in which you can choose how much you want to play, and then I don't need to explain that. Everybody knows what a Humble Bundle is. Anyway. After a while of doing Humble Bundles, they decided to open up their own store, the Humble Store, where you can buy games and redeem them on Steam, so at least they're doing the smart thing. And now we have become a Humble Bundle partner, a Humble Partner, which means you can buy games through our referral link. Use that link to buy stuff on Humble Bundle, and we get something out of it. But that's not the most important part. The most important part is that some of that earnings go into charities. There's several thousands of charities you can choose to have your money go to there on Humble, on the Humble Store. But the charity I have chosen to be the default charity has been the Wikipedia, the Wikipedia something, I don't know what they're called. It's like the Wikipedia Foundation or something. And the idea behind the Wikipedia is that everybody also knows what a Wikipedia is. It's a site to spread knowledge, and like I was explaining the other day, I feel like spreading knowledge is very important. Especially because they make the knowledge free for everybody all over the world. And it's something that helps everybody. It's not like, ah, let's build wells on this or that country. Or let's save the bears or save those animals. Knowledge is a thing that benefits all countries.